Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15 beta 3 has been out for a few days and just released for public beta testers. So it took a couple days for Apple to release it, but it's finally here. iOS 15 public beta 3 is now available also. And in the initial iOS 15 beta 3 what's new video, I mentioned all of the different changes. There were quite a few, but since then there's been many more discovered. Some you've sent me and I've found some as well. And so there's over 15 new changes I wanted to go over in this video. But before we go into that, I'm running a YouTube community poll. If you go to the zollotech YouTube channel, tap on community at the top. I run these every week as there's new updates. And you can see at the time of this video, there's 8.1K votes or 8,100 votes. If I refresh this, there's still about 8,100 votes. And we take this information from iOS 14.7 RC and iOS 15 beta 3 to better understand how battery life is, any remaining bugs and more. So I'll be covering that in a follow-up video in a couple days or a day or so. Now, the first thing also is many people are mentioning to me that YouTube picture-in-picture is now available depending on your country. Now, it does seem to be that you have to be a premium subscriber and have that setting. I did a separate video on that where you can use picture-in-picture in the native app on iPhone and iPad, but some people are seeing it, some are not. In the US, UK, and even some in India have told me it's there as well, but it should be rolling out eventually free to everyone. So hopefully we'll see that soon, but many of you are starting to see that. Now, the first new feature has to do with voice memos. This isn't anything terribly exciting, but there is a new splash screen for the voice memos app. So if you have voice memos, you go into it for the first time. When you do that, I took a screenshot of it. And when you do that, you get a new splash screen. It says your recordings everywhere, playback speed, and improved sharing, just telling you about the new features with iOS 15. So that's new in this update. Now, something that's fairly significant for all of us that beta test, if you go into settings, go into general, scroll down, you'll notice there's no longer a beta profile there. In fact, it's under VPN and device management now. They've moved it under this setting where you can set up new VPN connections, but also the configuration profile is here now. So before it was under the main setting page, now it's here, we can remove it or install new ones. So they've moved that around in this update. And so that's something they've changed as well. Now, something else they've changed in settings has to do with maps. So if we go down to maps and go into the map settings, if we go into beta 2, I have in my left hand on the iPhone 12 Pro, I've got the 12 Pro Max in my right hand. And if we go into the map settings, it looks pretty similar until you scroll down, you'll see that they've replaced navigation and guidance with the word spoken directions. And so if we go into that, you'll see it's also a little bit different where we have directions wake iPhone and also directions on radio. So they've updated this with new wording and just sort of updated the section overall. We could see this change in future updates, but that's something that's been changed also. Now, also under settings, if we go to general, and then scroll down, you'll see transfer or reset iPhone. Now, I talked about this in the first video, but if we go into transfer and reset iPhone, it looks a little bit different. And to get the same options we have on the left with beta 2, you actually have to tap reset. Then you get all of the same sort of options. It's a nicer look, a little bit different layout. And if you tap on get started, it gives you more information as well, saying you'll be ready for your new iPhone. That's it for now. Your iPhone is using iCloud to secure your data. So there's a new little splash screen explaining how it works. Use this iPhone to quickly sign in, trade in, or recycle this iPhone. So there's some new options there as well. Now, also, if we go into the control center on both of these and then go to the new focus modes, you'll see the focus modes here. However, if we tap on the plus button at the bottom, you'll see it looks a little bit different on the right with beta 3. We now have mindfulness that's been added. So that's something that's a little bit new. Everything else is very similar, but now we have mindfulness to set up by default. So you can set that up with mindfulness focus. And again, here's a new splash screen that says, don't miss out and share you're away and let others know that you're away. So it's a nice little update they've added. Now, something else that's new that I talked a little bit about in the first video is that they've updated the widget for music. However, it's even different if you have the larger widgets. So if you go into your music and maybe you play a song, let me turn the volume down. Maybe we play a song. I told you how it turned to sort of match the album art. And that part's really nice. But if we go over to the larger widget, they've redesigned the larger widget altogether. So I have the same widget on beta 2. Again, let's turn it all the way down, hit play. And if we go to that same widget, you'll see even with it playing, the widget didn't change. But on beta 3, it's a redesigned widget while playing, even if it's larger. So it not only matches the background, but has a redesign as well. Now on the iPad, there's some changes as well. And one of the new changes has to do with universal control. Now that is not yet active in beta 3 or macOS Monterey. However, if you go into your settings, go to general, and then go to AirPlay and handoff, you'll see it actually has an option for handoff. But if you turn this off and turn it back on, all of a sudden cursor and keyboard appears and it says, allow your cursor and keyboard to be used on any nearby Mac signed into your iCloud account. And so this hints that universal control will be here. We saw some options with macOS Monterey in the video I did there for universal control. It's not yet active, but some of these options are here. So it's nice to see them update that. So hopefully we'll see that in beta 4. Now, the first time I went into notes on the iPad, I actually got a little different notification in the upper left that said find images. It said search for text or things like dogs or beaches in the photos attached to your notes. And you can see this is some of the notes I started that I've already talked about. And you'll see I'm talking about one of them listed here, but there was this little pop-up telling me I could use Siri to search for the different things like animals, for example. So that's a little update I noticed when I was using it on the iPad with iPadOS 15 Beta 3. Now, also, if we go into Safari, you'll see that it looks fairly similar, but we now have the share icon back in the upper right. We had this come back on the Mac as well with Safari. And also there's a refresh button. Now, before we had to use the mouse or trackpad to mouse over this to see refresh. However, if we refresh the page, it now shows up and there's the refresh icon at the top. So that's just been updated in Safari as well. Also, if we go into the sidebar, there's a new section for shared with you. This is something that I've talked about with iOS 15, where maybe someone shares a link to you in your messages, it will now show up here. So you can see everything that was shared with you. Now within weather, there's a couple improvements as well. If we go into the weather app, and you'll see the temperature is not matching for some reason, but in the weather app, if we tap the little menu button in the bottom right, you'll see that they've improved the animations. So if we tap on those, on beta 2, it just sort of snaps to the weather locations. In beta 3, it's nice and smooth. So you'll see it's just nice and smooth in beta 3 compared to beta 2, for example. So that's updated. Also, if we scroll down and we go into temperature here, to the map, and then we switch to the map layer that says precipitation. We switch to that, scroll down, we'll go back, maybe see some of the precipitation, tap on it here, you'll see it says for the playback multi-day forecast, where before it just said hourly forecast. So they've just updated that, and you'll see the graphs a little bit different as well. So that's something that's a little different. I'm not sure if we'll be able to change this in the future, but that's been updated with multi-day forecast. Now in iOS 15, there's what's called a notification summary. You may or may not be familiar with this, and there's an update to it as well, where it gives you some more information. If you're not familiar with it, you can turn it on by going to Settings, Notifications, and you'll see Scheduled Summary. You can turn it on or off, and then have it deliver a summary based off the time of day, and also apps that you actually select. So you can turn those on or off, whatever you'd like, and it will give you a notification summary. The first time you see notification summary now, it will give you a splash screen that looks like this. It says reduce interruptions with notification summary, get the notifications you need immediately, and schedule a summary of the rest to be delivered later. And then it says see how it works, and then it's giving more information. So you'll see there's different versions of this. So it's just an update with a new splash screen explaining a new feature, but that's something new in beta 3. Now, if you're using a phone with Touch ID, there's a small change to the Touch ID icon or graphic. So you'll see this is what it looked like before. And in the new version, it's a little different where it's darker and has more of a highlighted look to it. So it's a little bit different. It's a small change, but it's something that is different. Now, also, there's an update to when you turn off your phone. Now, I've talked about this before with Find My. Now with iOS 15, if you have Find My iPhone turned on, it will now let it be located even if the phone is turned off. Now, the first time you go to try and turn your phone off, it will give you a little splash screen. And so that splash screen looks like this. It says iPhone remains findable after power off. Find My helps you locate this iPhone when it is lost or stolen, even when it is in power reserve mode or when powered off. You can change this Find My network functionality by going to Find My in settings. So that's something that's new. And also if you try and power off the phone, you could get a message like that as well. So if we power it off, see, we'll slide this off And it says at the bottom, iPhone findable after power off. So once it powers off, it's still findable using Find My. Now let me go ahead and power this back on. Now a user sent in that they saw something new when they were backing up their phone as well. And this is what it looked like. It was showing their iCloud backup status. I was not able to reproduce this, but this is what it looks like. I tried to back up my phone. I didn't see this. So I'd be curious to know if you're actually seeing this as well, but it's showing on the settings page, the actual backup status. I haven't seen it myself, but someone did send this to me, so I thought I'd mention it. Now, finally, there's a nice feature if you're using iCloud Plus and you want to hide your email. When you want to sign into a new website, you can go into the website. So we'll go to Safari and maybe we'll tap in the top to sign up. You have the option now to hide my email. So it shows up at the bottom along with your keychain passwords. Now you can tap on hide my email. It will pop up a new screen and help you hide your email from wherever you're creating the account with. So you'll see it will create a different email and then you have different settings for that also. So you can hit continue and then you can create that, use that email, put a label, make a note about it, and then use that for the email address. So we'll use that. It will take just a moment and now it fills it in by itself with an email address that will relay back to you, but is hidden from wherever you're signing up for. So that's built in and it will prompt you every time you go to sign up someplace now. So that's everything in iOS 15 beta 3 so far that I've been able to find and also found with the help of many of you. So thank you very much if you've sent those in. And also I'm looking forward to iOS 15 beta 4. I expect more changes there as well as Apple continues to refine iOS 15. Now expect that in about a week and a half or so, and then we'll get the final in late September, like I've said before. I'll also have that follow-up video in a day or so. I haven't decided which day to release it, but as you give me feedback in the YouTube community poll, I'll be sure to do a follow-up video talking about all of the different things and even more features if I find anything else. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.